is the pleasure. The rain was fallen, didn't say hard. The drains were overflowing. You'd almost think the flood was coming on. So they huddled in the corner, trying to keep it all the water. And he told her all the things he had in mind. If we come, we meet a fig tree. Well, he says to Caroline, I would give a happy heart. The pleasure will be mine, she says. The pleasure will be mine. The paper says the workforce will be laid off after Christmas. There's a downturn in the business, so they say. I'll sit about here and wait on some company's decision. So on Friday, I'll be left in my last pay.
City side.
ways. Made her stand out when she's throwed down the breeze. Four days a week she'd come visiting the town. She'd tack the breeze, rain, hail or shine. Her silver hair would be flaying in the wind. And folk thought her a creature mad or wild. When ice and snow dripped off the country, you'd see the smoke rise frae her chimney. The wild of low could then rise teasy for Jenny the breeze. The wind blew always round the muir. It rattled on her cottage window. She sat inside, close by the fire. She was content in her own company. And if you asked her if she was weel, she'd say, I'm grand, sir, how's yourself? And then she'd trod John up the hill. Jenny the Breeze. She was neat bothered, her much we gave. She lived on cheese breed, oats and barley. She was neat flashed, we trumped her tail. She'd spurn the knock that broke to helping hand. Sometimes she'd wander o'er the mule, collecting heather, plants and flowers, and singing softly to herself, Jenny of the Breeze. Last year she died, made it day. Cottage door was seldom open, and when the spring flowers come to bloom, she hardly ever ventured down the bays. One day when someone was out walking, they saw her chimney was nae smoking. They found her sitting in the kitchen, a smile upon her face. Jenny. As I was crossing Ardboyne water, my friends and acquaintances to see, for the killing of an English lord, my good great sword they've taken frae me. As I looked over my left shoulder, it was to see what I could see. There I spied a bonny boy, way heavy arms to lay.